Philippine Central Bank finally hitting pause on its rate hikes. Its decision to keep the benchmark rate at 6.25% is the first after a year of aggressive tightening to curb inflation. The Banco Central kept its rates steady, citing inflation that cooled further to 6.6% in April. Also factoring in the 6.4% economic growth in the first quarter.
Given these considerations, the Monetary Board deems it prudent for the BSP to take a pause in monetary policy tightening while remaining ready to respond to emerging threats to inflation. A prudent pause also allows monetary authorities to further assess how macroeconomic and financial conditions will evolve in view of tighter global financial conditions.
The BSP also lowered its inflation outlook for this year from the previous 6.1%. It's now at 5.5. For next year, it sees the consumer price index falling further to 2.8%.
A Philippine House panel eyeing possible charges against the alleged onion cartel. During the conclusion of the Committee on Agriculture and Food's ninth hearing on the issue, Marikina Representative Stella Quimbo says the committee is having a hard time formulating their findings since they doubt the testimonies of those who faced the panel. That includes Lea Cruz, who has been identified as the center of the controversy. Quimbo notes Cruz allegedly operates the biggest onion cartel in the country. The House panel expects to submit its report on the onion investigation in the next 2 weeks. The Philippine Agriculture Department assures the public measures are in place in the biofertilizer program, which is meant to address the high cost of farm inputs and boost rice production. Concerns have been raised of a repeat of the fertilizer fund scam amid the government's push for biofertilizers. Senior Agriculture Undersecretary Leocadio Sebastian says there are enough safeguards to ensure the proper procurement and distribution of the product. Sebastian adds the government will procure locally produced biofertilizers.
So doon sa Memorandum 32, nakalaan doon na kailangan yung biofertilizer ay cost-effective siya. So ibig sabihin, hindi siya magpapataas ng gastos ng magsasaka na malulugi siya. So kung tataas man ang gastos, tataas din dapat yung ani na mas malaki pa. Matapos, kinakailangan din yung biofertilizer na ipapagamit natin sa mga magsasaka, rehistrado yan. Hindi lang yung lusaw na ginawa lang sa likod ng bahay. Saka rehistrado yung mga kumpanya.
Back in the early 2000s, several agriculture officials were accused of diverting hundreds of millions of pesos in fertilizer funds to allegedly back the presidential campaign of former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo.
Nine Filipinos allegedly trafficked in Malaysia and Thailand brought home last week. In a statement, the Philippine Immigration Bureau said six victims from Thailand were promised high-paying customer service jobs, but they were forced to work in online love scams and cryptocurrency rings. Meanwhile, the three victims from Malaysia were made to believe they would be employed as massage therapists. They were forced into sex work and allegedly continued to experience abuse even after being rescued by Malaysian authorities. Immigration Chief Norman Tansinko reminds the public to practice vigilance against human trafficking schemes.